dog. Walk away. Turn around. Good. Come back here. Come to a stop. Down your dog. Good.
Papa, guess what? I got my pink ribbon.
I know, I saw. Pick up your dog's face. Tell your dog in place.
Oh.
Okay. And pick up your dog's leash. You have to wait here until mama comes back to give the leave and look for them. Until mama comes back, here you go. You leave your dog. You know, all the way down to the blue line. Don't let other dogs come near her.
Right here.
Go all the way down there. Deal? What's your word? Hi, this is Jeff Gelman of Solid Canine Training with a new training video. This is going to be on proper healing a dog on a leash, or we call it loose leash walking. Now, I've got a 6-foot cotton lead. If we can't walk our dog, we don't train our dog. Remember, the loose leash walk is highly important if you want to train your dog 100% to the off leash train. The first part of my training film is going to be on the basics. Part 2 is going to be on distractions. How do we start? I've put my training collar on my dog. This is Kendall. Kendall's a female and she's actually up for adoption. I'm going to train with my dog on my left hand side. My dog should always be right next to my left leg. Notice how I'm holding on to my leash like a bicycle, but down low. Like a bicycle, but down low. All my dog needs is 12 to 18 inches of leash. That's all the dog needs. Now, your dog should not be out in front of you when it's walking. It should not be behind you, and it should not be too far to the left. When we walk our dog on a leash, we do not allow our dogs to sniff, to mark, to pull, to lag behind, to bark, nothing. So, minimal amount of words as well. The command is going to be heel. Heel means at my side, at my pace. So, I start my dog like this in a loose leash fashion. The end result is I want my leash to always be loose on my dog. Yes, we can control our dog. If it's pulling on the leash, we can move right, we can move left, but our body should be loose. Walks are supposed to be relaxing. Here's a great training example for me. When my dog does that without permission, all I did was do this, because I didn't tell it to down. When I'm walking my dog, I don't look at the dog, I just start walking and say, heel. Slight pops I have to give my dog if it gets ahead of me. When I am walking and I pop, my dog looks up at my head. This is how it looks from behind. Let me show you a turn. When I turn, I pop and pop. We'll do that a couple times. When I turn, if I'm going to make a turn to my right, I'm going straight like this, my body goes like this, and then like this. So I will pop the leash there, and I will pop the leash here. Watch. Heel. I pop and pop. Watch again. I pop and pop.
All times. When we come to a stop, we want our dogs to automatically go into the sitting position, waiting for us. Now, why is this important? Well, when my dog is sitting there like this, it's not jumping up on somebody, it's not eating stuff off the ground, it's not biting anybody. They rarely bark when they're in this. What I just did, Kendall's head went down, and I just lifted Kendall's head up. I'm the pack leader. When Kendall's off leash running around, he can sniff, roll over, turn right, turn left, lie down, roll on his back, I don't care. But right now, we are training. Part of training is listening to us. This is for mental and physical exercise. So, when I'm ready to go, I give the command, heel, and I walk. Notice how my body is relaxed. Remember, when we want to make our turns to the right, we're going to do a two-pop turn. When we turn from straight to this side, we're going to make a pop and then again to this side. Watch. Heel, heel, heel. The reason I do that is this. Watch this turn now without any leash pops. Heel, heel, heel. Did you see the head? Watch again. Heel, 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 heel. We're training our dog to, and then automatically SIT, which is the sit command, without being told. That's why we give them the gentle pop. The pop is a communication with the dog. It doesn't harm the dog, it doesn't stress the dog, it does not make the dog aggressive. Anyone that says that pinch collars make dogs aggressive doesn't understand canine behavior. We're not hanging the dog, we're not choking the dog. This is not proper. Just a quick pop up like this. That causes less stress on it than if we had to pick up the dog from the nylon collar. How many times are we grabbing onto the nylon collars trying to get our lunging? That actually causes tracheal damage. So again, hands like a bicycle. The dog has just this much leash. It's all this dog needs. I don't go like this anymore. We don't do this anymore. I don't need to. Heel. When I make my turns, I want them to be a sharp turn. I want my turns to be sharp. This is training. I can just give little tiny pops, and my dog follows me. When I come to a stop, I want my dog to get a dog to do an automatic sit when we want. Well, when I come to a stop, I don't want to say the sit command. Part of proper healing is sitting automatically. So, what I do at first is I will give my dog the pop. So when I am walking with my dog, and I come to a stop, I will pop the leash in an upward pop. Gentle. Look what happens. Again, heel,